reveal that to you also. However, let us keep living by that same standard to which we have attained. Brethren, join in following my example and observe those who walk according to the pattern you have in us. For many walk, of whom I often told you, and now tell you even weeping, that they are enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction. With God is their appetite, and whose glory is in their shame, who set their minds on earthly things. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform the body of our humble state into conformity with the body of his glory, by the exertion of the power that he has even to subject all things to himself. Therefore, my beloved brethren, whom I long to see, my joy and crown, in this way stand firm in the Lord, my beloved. And the Lord bless his word to our hearts this morning. Let us pray. Lord God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for your precious word. We thank you that till now we are able to possess it in abundance, freely share it, distribute it, study it, with so much help available to us. How many saints of the past and even of the present would have sacrificed life and limb for even just a little of what we have available. Father, never has there been such a time as the days we live in, where we have so much information, in a time where false teaching and deception are so abound. We ask you, creating us a longing for your word, may our devotions be characterized with the hunger and the thirst to know it, and to know it deeply. Teach us to treasure your word while we still have it. As in the words of Job, that we would treasure the words of your mouth more than our necessary food. Father, we thank you for these life-giving truths we just read. I pray that our worship this morning would be for each one of us in the Spirit of God, and our boast be in the Lord Jesus Christ alone. That we would not put any confidence in the flesh, a reliance on any of our achievements, or anything resembling a righteousness or a commendation of our own before you. Rather, may our confidence and boast be in the justifying act of God declaring us as righteous. A righteousness from God based on faith alone, in the Lord Jesus Christ alone. Grant us a faith, Father, that counts all things as lost, more precisely as excrement, as Paul tells us here. The total and glad abandonment of all else to gain the supreme knowledge of Christ, that we may personally know him, not just about him. To know the life-giving power of his resurrection working out in our lives, and the fellowship of his sufferings. Grant us a faith, Father, that allows for suffering, sickness, persecution, and even conformity to his death if you committed so. So God, may your spirit of truth, the paraclete whom you've given to be with us and in us, to empower us, to guide us in all truth, to comfort us, may he cause the seed of these truths to take root in us and bear much fruit. Help us, Lord, to forget whatever hindrances, disappointments, and failures may lay behind us. Cause us to strive forward towards the goal for the prize of the upward call, the prize for which we were already laid hold of by the Savior. Lord, as we're about to begin a new year, help us maintain this attitude in us. We ask that your power would rest upon us and renew us. Reveal the greatness of these truths in each and every heart this morning, and reassure us of your presence. In the most precious name of Jesus.